Hi everyone, it's time for another Squishy Makeover with me, Squishy Exclusive. So I've got this large panda keychain, nice and squishable. I'm going to make a giant version of the smaller frog keychains that I showed in a previous video but didn't film the actual makeover. So first of all, as always, give the squishy a sanding to help the paint stick to it. I'm starting with a base coat. I would normally use white, but because it's going to be a green frog, I thought green would be fine. What you'll notice is that the squishy is so porous, it's actually soaking up the paint. So the base coat is basically doing all the hard work, so the real colour won't need as many layers. Now the base coat is done on both sides. It's left us with a really nice texture, really froggy texture, if you know what I mean. Still squishable. So now it's time to start creating our frog. The colour is a nice deep green colour. It's actually leaf green and it's straight from the tube. You can see how great the coverage is of the colour, and that's because of the base coat. So we'll only need about two or three layers of this green. I'll do one side, leave it to dry, and then do the other side. So there we are, that's done. Now onto the back, and I'm doing something a bit different with the back. I'm just dropping the paint straight on from the tube. Because it's a large flat surface, instead of using a paintbrush, I'm just going to smooth it down with a popsicle stick, try and create a nice smooth layer. I'll leave this to dry for a day or two and then come back and do one more layer over the top. Now I'm just contemplating if I'm happy with it or not, or do I keep fiddling with it? I think it's okay. So I'm going to leave it now and we'll come back and see where we are. So now it's dry, I am just going to test the squishability, and it's still really good. Next up will be the eyes of the frog. The bear had ears, which are now going to be the eyes of the frog. I'm using puffy paint straight from the tube to create a nice circle. The puffy paint will make sure it stays nice and 3D. And then I'm going to add a black pupil on top, but only when the white paint has dried completely, which will take a few days. I'll just put it aside, leave it for a few days until it's completely dry. And here's what I ended up with. So, as with the small frog keychains, our big frog is going to get some coloured spots on the front and the back. So you can see my little colour palette there where I was testing colours. But first of all, I'm going to mark where I want the spots to go with white. And this will make the actual colour really pop and stand out against the dark green. So I'm just going in with a dotting tool, trying to keep these spots as round as possible and obviously matching on each side. That won't take too long to dry. So here were the colour options that I had. These colours are good because they're so bright, they really stand out against the dark green. So I decided to go for orange on the front. I think it really pops against the green. So yeah, just going in with the dotting tool again and going over the white. Once that's done, leave to dry because you don't want any smudging when you're doing the other side. Now that's dry, we can do exactly the same on the other side. Incidentally, this has got to be the biggest keychain or charm I've ever seen. I mean, what are you going to use it for? It's too big to hang on a phone or anything. I've no idea. Anyway, here we go again with the white dots, and I'm just randomly going in. I've not planned it. Adding different sizes, just until it looks good. Leave that to dry, and now we're going to add the colours. Now, I'm not just making them orange. I'm going to do multicoloured. I don't think there are any real frogs that look like this, but that's not the point of a squishy makeover, is it? I decided to go for orange, blue and pink. No particular reason, I just randomly picked them. And we'll see how it turns out. Now once this is done and all dry, the squishy will be finished. Let's see what the original squishy was like. It was a very squishable but slightly grimy panda bun. And here's the finished squishy. A million times improvement, I think you'll agree. I really love it. It was easy to make, very squishable, and the texture turned out to be perfect for a frog. Here's a comparison with one of the mini frog keychains that I made. You can see how much bigger it is. He's like the big brother frog, but rest assured he will be staying in my collection, he won't be sold. So that's it from me, thanks for watching. More squishy makeovers on the way, and it's bye from me, Squishy Exclusive. Bye!